Hello, everyone. Today we've got a very simple yet interesting idea. We're going to take a look at all the geodes and compare them. More specifically, we're going to compare whether it's worth it to process them or sell them as you find them. Taking a look, we've got regular geodes, frozen geodes, magma geodes, and omni geodes. These are about the order you find them in and their rarity and value, so on and so forth. I've actually often wondered this myself, though I've never really looked into it. This idea, I believe, came from the comments of my last video. It was brought forward to me through someone else who showed me from the comments, so whoever suggested that, thanks a lot, great idea. I honestly really don't know what to expect from this idea, so we're just gonna dive right into it. I think I'm probably gonna process 30 of each geode. That should be a good enough number to give you an average of what they can give you. Obviously, the regular geode, they can't really find you much interesting stuff, or maybe they can, I'm not entirely sure. The omni geodes have the most potential to actually be worth something. For those of you that aren't super familiar with the geodes, you find them while you're mining. For the most part, you can find them elsewhere, but basically the deeper down you go, the higher quality the geodes are. So right at the beginning, you'll find regular geodes, you move on to frozen in the frozen levels, magma as you get deeper, and omni geodes at the bottom. Though magma and omni geodes are somewhat interchangeable from what I understand, but maybe this test will help us determine that once and for all. You can also find just the regular geodes around town. I remember finding one in my field when I first started playing and got really excited because I thought I found something rare. Turns out it was garbage, but it was exciting when I found it. So smash rocks on your farm. On occasion, you'll find a geode. Maybe it has something valuable. Who knows? I think the first thing I'm going to do is simply sell 30 of every geode. That way I can simply see the value of that. Then we know once we process them if it's worth it to do so or just sell them as you find them. Obviously, there are some other factors involved. Maybe you want the artifacts from the geodes to finish your museum collection. I've done that before. I've simply bought a bunch of geodes from the desert. You can buy them from Sandy, I believe, on Wednesdays. I'll confirm that. And then processed them all, and I got a whole bunch of artifacts for the museum, which got me the sewer keys, or something like that. So, the value of these things, they're considered other. 9,000. I wonder if they're worth equal values. Nope, definitely not. Interestingly enough, they actually work out pretty nicely. I mean, regular geodes 1500, the next rare are worth twice as much, and the magma are worth 3 times as much. But then, very interestingly, omni geodes are not worth anything to sell. You can pay to buy them, they're not worth anything to sell, so obviously processing them is going to be worth it, but we need to look at the actual value of processing them. You know what? I was going to go see Clint today. He opens at 9 o'clock. He's actually open for very short hours. He's a very lazy blacksmith, but I'm actually going to wait till Wednesday because I think that's when Sandy sells him in the desert because I want to make sure I'm right with that. Might as well cover all things geode in this video because in a perfect world, you'd be able to buy the omni geodes and then process them and make a profit. That would just be infinite money essentially, and that would be really cool. These cost 1,000 each, so that's probably not going to happen, but you never know. 1,000 gold to buy these. And you have infinite of them, so if you need artifacts, go spend 1,000 gold, buy 50 of those. You'll probably get 20 new artifacts out of the deal, maybe more if you don't have a lot of museum stuff already done. Now for the part that's going to take a long time. I'll do these one at a time. I'll do all the regular geodes first, I'll sell them. I'll do all the frozen geodes, sell them, and we'll take a look at what they're giving us. So without further ado, let's get started. Our very first artifact is 5 rocks. We're off to a great start. I also just realized that I probably should have emptied out my backpack before I started this. I forgot how many items you can get from these. That's not the end of the world. If I have to, I can warp back to the farm, sell the stuff, come back. But we might get a lot of overlap items too. I feel like I'm going to get a lot of rocks and a lot of coal and a lot of ore. Well, alright, our hardworking blacksmith is done smashing geodes. I don't know why I pay him to do that. I think I could probably hit them with a hammer. Whatever the case, let's take a look at what we got. All sorts of stuff. Nothing really jumps out at me here. Some of these are pretty valuable. You can see thanks to my UI Info Suite mod that you can see the value right away. But nothing outrageously valuable, but as long as it's worth more than 1500 gold, they're worth processing. Time to run all the way back to the farm, throw these in the bin, and we'll get our result. I think it's going to be worth more than the 1500 gold, but I could be wrong. The trick is, you don't want to throw any of the other geodes in the bin. That will skew the result, so I need to actually pay attention here. And that's everything. Anyone want to take a guess on how much this stuff's worth? I'm actually kind of leaning toward about 1,000 gold, but I could be wrong. I wasn't really paying attention to what I had there. Is it over 1,500? It is just over 1,500. Okay, well, total of 1,800. So it is worth it to process those. You can sell them for 1,500 without taking a time, but there you have 1,800 gold. But you need to remember the processing fee that Clint charges you. Clint charges you 25 gold per geode processed. That 25 gold times 30 geodes actually equals 750 gold. So you're left with far less. So after the processing fee, you're left with 1,069 gold, which is almost 500 gold less than if you just throw the geodes straight in a bin by themselves. So in this case, if you're looking for money, sell the geodes themselves. Don't process them, don't waste the time. Unless you need artifacts for the museum, then yeah, you probably want to do that because you're not really going to make a lot of money off these anyway. But there you go, that's a definitive answer for regular geodes. Let's move on to the next ones. But before I do that, let's get rid of some of my stuff in my backpack. If I have any empty chests, that is, some of these are probably pretty full. That's so much better. I do have 36 total spaces in my backpack, so processing 30 geodes shouldn't be a problem. Alright, Clint, this time I want some valuables. I'm not sure at what point you even have the chance to produce something like a prismatic shard or a diamond, which would really make the result worthwhile, because a diamond's worth 750 gold and a prismatic shard is worth 2,000 all by itself. And you're probably going to need some of those items to justify this cost, but like I said, we'll see the result once we're done. Alright, so after a minor, small little error that I don't want to talk about, we're done processing the frozen geodes. This is all we got. One thing I do kind of notice is there are more minerals and less of the generic ores and rocks and stuff, so hopefully we get a lot more value out of those. The number we're looking to beat now would be 3,000 gold for the price of the raw geodes plus the 750 for the processing fee, so 3,750. Do we have that kind of value in here? I doubt it, but you might be surprised. Some of those minerals are actually fairly surprisingly valuable. To be honest though, I do still have my doubts, but we'll find out right now. Numbers moving up, and not even close. So 3,271 gold, so about 2,500 gold after the processing fee, so that is 500 gold less than selling the geodes just raw in their frozen form. Quick look at the breakdown of the items, should you want to see. Nothing particularly valuable there. These are worth 200 each. Things are worth 200-250 gold, looks like, on average. But the magma geodes might be where things all change, because they can drop some pretty valuable stuff, I'm pretty sure of that, so we'll find out. They're also quite a bit harder to get and rarer than the other two. The other two are actually fairly common, these ones I feel like are harder to get. But only one way to know for sure. Just gotta pay that idiot to smash another 30 rocks for me. What a ripoff. I feel like everyone in this town is trying to rip me off. But I have so much money that I just don't really care. What's our first item gonna be? A rock. It's always a rock, it never changes. Right, red, fire, magma geodes, all done. These things, I feel like they look more valuable. There's a lot of nice weird colors in there, but only one way to find out. So the number we're looking to beat this time is going to be 5,250 gold, and I have absolutely zero faith we're going to get there. I just don't see that much value in this stuff. So honestly, I'm predicting a pretty close number to the frozen geode, somewhere in the 3,000 to 4,000 gold range. I don't think it's going to be anything more than that. Oh, well, there you go, it is a little bit more, 4,750, so you knock off the fee from that and you're at a cool, clean 4,000 gold. And you know what? I'm detecting another trend here. Every time you process the geodes, you're left with 500 gold less than the raw value of the geodes themselves. That has been really consistent so far with all the geodes. Obviously, the Omni geodes are going to change because, well, they're not worth anything to sell themselves. Neptunite, if you got a few more of those, that would be quite valuable. Star shards too, 500 gold. So we are getting some more valuable items, 450, but not enough there to make a difference. Now we're left with simply the rarest of all, the Omni Geodes, and if you have a statue of Endless Fortune, you're probably going to get a lot of these from there, which might have a factor in why they're not worth anything to sell by themselves. But these definitely can give you some valuable stuff, especially if I get a prismatic shard, that would be huge. 30 Omni Geodes, nicely processed. Now, I'm not seeing anything drastically exciting. Like I said, I'm not really familiar with these, but I don't think we're going to get any more value than the lava geodes, to be honest, because there's just not really anything more valuable. Once you get into items worth 400 or 500 gold, there's not really anything more valuable with the exception of diamonds and prismatic shards, like I've been saying. So I predict similar value to the last one, but obviously worth it to process these because they're not worth anything. And the value of 30 processed rarest geodes there ever was, aka the Omni geodes, is not that much at all, only 3,300, so the lava geodes, the magma geodes, are actually worth considerably more. But then again, you have to process the Omni geodes, otherwise you're just wasting your time. Now, to be fair, if you get even one prismatic shard, it's going to change this number in a big way, but whatever the case, it's not really going to still be worth that much more than the magma geode. So you're looking at a total of just over 2,500 gold in value once you take off the processing fee. Interesting. So the Omni geode's value is basically the same as the frozen geodes. Well, there you have it. If you sell the geodes raw, if you have 30 of them, you're going to make about 500 gold more to sell them raw as opposed to processing them. Now, however, that's not a lot of money. You might want the artifacts instead for the museum. There was a whole bunch of artifacts there. I didn't count them. There's probably 50 artifacts there to donate to the museum. Is it worth it to process the geodes? No, not from a monetary standpoint. You'll make 500 gold less, over 30 geodes, not a big deal either way. If you haven't seen my channel before, go ahead and check it out. Lots of other videos just like this in there already. New videos up all the time, trying to get two a day out. New videos, new games, new ideas, blah 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 blah. Anyways, I hope you like this one. Thank you all for watching.